Good day to you, and welcome to this presentation on Unit 2, where we are looking at the computer system. And when you look at the computer system, we are looking at various components that can be connected to the computer to bring effectiveness and efficiency as you are operating or as you are working on the computer. So yes, we do understand that there are four main components of the computer: hardware, and these are the CPU, the monitor, which is also called the screen, the mouse, as well as the keyboard. These are key. However, there are several other components that can be connected to the computer to enhance the performance of certain activities that you want to work on. So let's try to look at the computer system in details. So we are saying the computer is made up of the hardware and the software. And the hardware, these are physical components of the computer that can be touched and manipulated. The components that we are able to see, that we can lift, touch, and manipulate so as to perform the activities that we want. So now the computer system made up of hardware components may be divided into three main categories, and these are the input and output. Then we also have the system box. So when talking about the central processing unit, we can connect as many devices as we can. And all these connections, all these devices may be divided into two. They are either input or output devices. Now, when we say input devices and output devices, we are talking about the computer processing cycle. So the cycle starts with putting in information into the computer. Then you work on it to process that information, you summarize, you come up with diagrams, charts, or reports. Thereafter, you can save, retrieve, or you can report, meaning you can communicate. And that is now output, where you want what you are working on to be known by the general public or by your bosses or by the stakeholders. So you need to make up some reports, and you need devices to help you come up with that output activity or to perform that output activity. So we, in this cycle, processing cycle, we've got the input activities and output activities. The input activities are those activities that are to do with the putting in of information into the system, into the computer. And those may be keying in information when you're using, let's say, the keyboard. So it has these different sets of keys. So you key in information into the computer. Also you can also record. You are putting in information. That's a recordings and an input activity, typings and an input activity, among others. Output, we've got the reporting, communicating. Those are output activities. But what devices do we need for us to put in information into the computer? Those are the devices we are going to discuss in this presentation. So the main components of the personal computer, we are saying we've got the central processing unit, hard disk where information is stored, output devices that you're going to look at, as well as the output devices. Look at these a little bit closer in details in this presentation. So the central processing unit, as we discussed earlier, it has got three main components. The ALU, which is the arithmetic logic unit. So everything that is done using the computer, there must be some logical in the way information is being presented. arithmetic, something to do with calculations, computations. For example, you're using Excel, using the computer, there are different formulas that you can use. Yeah, all those can compute whatever data you have because of the arithmetic components. The logic is whereby you want to arrange information, whether in ascending or descending order, whether in alphabetical order, whatever order, that logic way of presenting things or of doing things on the computer is being controlled by the ALU, arithmetic logic unit. Then the other important component is the control unit. This controls all the activities in the computer. For example, if you command transfer, it has to transfer. If you command this, for example, you plug in the flash disk to your PC, to your computer. PC means personal computer. So you plug in the flash. The computer, the system has to detect to say there is something plugged in, and quickly it will show. And if there is some antivirus, to start scanning immediately. If there is something harmful, there must be something to control, to detect that, so that the computer is not damaged. So the control unit is in charge of that orderly in the way things must be done on the computer. Then the other important component is the memory. And you've got different types of memories. You've got primary, secondary, primary. This is the memory that can be lost anytime power goes, it will disappear. Secondary, this is external storage where information can be stored for future use using external devices. Primary, we can also subdivide it into various components. For example, the ROM, read-only memory, RAM, read, random access memory, where information is volatile, it can be distorted, it can disappear as soon as power goes and so forth, it can be lost anytime. Well, read-only memory, ROM, information may be there for years and years. The cache is memory where information is stored when you are working on it. So quickly, let's try to look at the hardware, components of the computer that support the four main hardware components. And these are talking about input and output. So what are the input devices? So we've got the keyboard. So this keyboard is an input device. It's used to put in information into the computer, an input device. The mouse, it has got all these buttons, okay, to issue commands to the computer. So it's an input device. The scanner, you want to scan your photo, your certificates, your documents, you put on the scanner, then it captures more like a picture in picture form, which you can also put in PDF or whatever form you want. You can save it in various forms of documents. So that information, that document or that file will be transmitted from the scanner to the computer, central processing unit. And the central processing unit will show it on the desktop to say, scan, this is the document. So the scanner feeds into the computer, captures the photo, captures whatever you're scanning, and feeds into the computer. It is an input device and not output. Mark that one. Even at hospital, there is a scanner which can be pressed anywhere, then it captures that part, and want to see what is inside the ear. And that whatever is there will be captured and transmitted or transferred to the CPU. Then the CPU receives. So the scanner is feeding to the CPU, and the CPU you can show it on some screen or monitor so that the doctors can look at it, read and interpret what is captured. So a scanner is an input device. Digital camera, you've captured something, then you connect to the CPU so that those photos are transferred or feeds into the system. That is an input device. the webcam is an input device. More modern computers, especially laptops, they have got a camera when you open the laptop. Some most of the phones, they have got the camera. So it's more like a webcam, no? It's called webcam, especially on laptops. So it's an input device. It captures and feeds into the system. The phone captures and feeds into the entire system. Then it is shown on the screen or on the monitor. So it's an input device, joystick used to writing, trackball also to track and write, the touch pads, okay, where you are touching. It's an input device. For example, touch screens, they may bring pads and touch there to, so it's an input feeding into the system. Then you've got light panes, and you're doing voters and sign on some screen there, voters card, and some those of them gone through that process. You sign on some screen using the light pen, and that signature is captured and put on the